Let me tell you something, church. If we ever fully grasp a hold of the vision and the plan that God has for each of us and realize it's so much bigger than what our little pea brain can even comprehend, we are in fact truly going to turn this world upside down and fully begin to do the things that God wants us to do. You know how that it's unlawful. What he's basically telling them is, y'all know what I'm doing by being here with you kind of peoples.
Mm-hmm.
Right.
Y'all might be getting a little nervous. That's why we're so quiet. I hope it's because you're soaking it up and realize that everybody, the reason why we pray every day is not for the Lord to let me to make it to work and have more money in my pocket. The reason why we pray every day is so we can say, honestly, Lord, change me.
Amen.
I want to grow today. I want to do something good today. You know how it is unlawful thing for a man that is a Jew to keep company or come under one of another nation? But God hath showed me that I should not call any man common or unclean. Therefore, came I unto you without gainsaying as soon as I was sent for. He's trying to come off as something to these people that he really wasn't in the beginning. Now, he did obey the Lord, but after the Lord had taken him to the woodshed. I ask therefore for what intent ye have sent for me. This shows us that Peter's still struggling with this whole thing. And then Cornelius begins retelling his story to Peter in verse 30. And Cornelius said, 4 days ago I was fasting until this hour. And at the ninth hour I prayed in my house, and behold, a man stood before me in bright clothing, and said, Cornelius, thy prayers heard, and thy alms are had in remembrance in the sight of God. Are y'all hearing the word of the Lord this morning? Oh, how many people has the devil sold a bill of goods to that says, see, it don't make a difference. See, you giving and you praying and you reading your Bible and you're fasting, ain't nothing happening. Come on, rebuke him, resist him, the Bible says. Resist him, because the Lord is paying attention. Thine alms are had and thy prayers heard in remembrance in the sight of God. Send therefore to Joppa and call hither Simon, whose surname is Peter. He is lodged in the house of one Simon a tanner by the seaside, who when he cometh shall speak unto thee. Then Cornelius says, immediately, therefore I sent to thee, and thou hast well done that thou art come. Now therefore are we all here present before God to hear all things that are commanded thee of God. We want to, my Lord Jesus, have mercy. Ooh. We want to hear from your lips what God has told you to say. Verse 33 shows the humility of Cornelius, but also his awareness that something bigger than him has happened. Kind of like something's moving. Something's changing. See his glory. Feels like heaven on earth. Something's moving. Something's changing. His prompt obedience speaks volumes of his character. A soldier, a commander in a position of authority, is immediately obedient to God. Where would we be as a church if we would receive the spirit of Cornelius? And when the Lord leads us, we would immediately obey. Verse 34, this is so beautiful. It's when the light bulb went off. We know that Peter still doesn't get it all together. Peter still wrestles with it the rest of his life. But he said, he opened up his mouth and said, of a truth, I perceive, I am aware. All of a sudden I realize what God has been trying to tell me, that he is no respecter of persons. The revelation has been received, both in his purposeful leading to a people that was beneath him, and the message of salvation. Because look here in verse 35. But in every nation, he that
and worketh righteousness is accepted. Is accepted with him. This message of salvation, the same message of salvation given to the Jews. And you remember this, some things happened in Peter's life. Because look here, in Luke 24, 47 through 48, and this is Jesus Christ speaking to Peter and the rest of the apostles, and that repentance and remission of sins should be preached in his name among all nations, beginning at Jerusalem. And ye are witnesses of these things. Look here, Acts 1 and 8. But ye shall receive power after that the Holy Ghost has come upon you, and ye shall be witnesses unto me both in Jerusalem and in all Judea and in Samaria and in the uttermost parts of the earth. But Acts chapter number 2 and verse number 38 says, then Peter said unto them, repent and be baptized every one of you in the Christ for the remission of sins, and you shall receive the gift of the Holy Ghost. But that ain't the best part of this shit. For the promise is unto you and unto your children and to all them that are born, even as many as the Lord our God shall call. We've got to get excited. I perceive that God is no respecter of persons. That's why we're going to love the wide open. I said we're going to love the wide open. We're going to love people that don't look like us, that don't talk like us, that don't come from the same background as us. Because you know what, Brother Billy, we talked about it this morning, that used to be us. If we got 100 people in here, 95 of them came from somewhere else. You people didn't come from here. We all came from somewhere else. We were all strangers before we were brother. But by the grace of God, he allowed us to experience his salvation and the blessings of the Lord. Yes. Don't you dare look down at your nose at somebody that don't talk like you do. Oh, I said it. I said it. There's rules and procedures to follow, and I think we should follow them. But the first look some of my people had was Lady Liberty out in the harbor when they came here from somewhere else. Can I get an amen up in the house? That's good. That's that sense of entitlement that I'm talking about with God. Just because you're fourth or fifth or sixth generation that came over here, you better understand something. The Lord ain't worried about your nationality or where you came from or who your mom and daddy was. The Lord is worried about who your next nationality is going to be. The Lord is worried about where your next homeland is going to be. The Lord is worried about where your next bloodline is going to be. We are just building the strangers here on earth. If it wasn't for the grace of God, I don't know where I would be. I was the son of a drunk who came from a long line of drunks. And if it hadn't been for the grace of God, I could have awoken this morning in the gutter covered in my own vomit.
Amen.
Thank
God.
And I know, Lord, I know what would have been for him. Brother Billy, I know him. I know me. And I know my weaknesses, and I know my capabilities. And if it wasn't for the Holy Ghost and the grace of God, getting liquored up would have been the least of my problems. I'd try to put everything down me, in me, through me, and around me that I possibly could. Because, Sister Maria, I'm weak. But by the grace of God. Thank you. stop sometimes and say, thank you, Jesus, that you're no respecter of persons. Thank you, Jesus, that you're no respecter of persons. I don't deserve this. I'm going to read something to you right now. Peter's entire message. The effectiveness of which was accompanied with two things. Cornelius' desire and Peter's awareness. Acts chapter 10, verse 36 through 43. And I will tell you, I know y'all talk about me preaching a long time and stuff. I'd rather not. And if our faith will rise up as we hear the word of the Lord, you'll make it so I can't preach long. The word which God sent unto the children of Israel, preaching peace by Jesus Christ, He is Lord of all. That word I say, ye know, which was published throughout all Judea, began from Galilee after the baptism which John preached. What was the baptism John preached? I indeed baptize you with water unto repentance. But there's coming one after me that's mightier than I. He will baptize you with the Holy Ghost and fire. How God anointed Jesus of Nazareth with the Holy Ghost and with power, who went about doing good and healing all that were oppressed of the devil. For God was with him, and we are witnesses of all things which he did, both in the land of Jews and in Jerusalem, whom they slew and hanged on a tree. Him God raised up the third day and showed him openly, not to all the people, but unto witnesses chosen before of God, even to us, who did eat and drink with him after he rose from the dead. And he commanded us to preach unto the people and to testify that it is he which was ordained of God to be the judge of the quick and the dead. To him give all the prophets witness that through his name whosoever believeth in him shall receive remission of sins. And I just read to you Peter's entire sermon in Cornelius' house. The entire sermon. Because we get so wrapped up in pomp and circumstance, we get so wrapped up and I got to meet all of my points and I got to fill all of this. And the truth of the matter is, God is just waiting on a faithful response. Because the Bible says in verse number 44, while Peter yet spake these words, the Holy Ghost fell. Oh, God, you got to see it. On all them which... Why? Brother Pete, you know what? That was all they were there for. They weren't there to feel nothing. They weren't there to have a bunch of singing and a whole bunch of stuff. You know what Cornelius had him there for? To hear what he had to say. And when he heard the word, the Bible says the Holy Ghost fell on all of them that heard the word. What happened when they heard the word? Faith was given birth to it. And they began to believe what thus saith the word of the Lord. And the Bible says the Holy Ghost fell on all of them which heard the word. And look here, verse number 45. And they of the circumcision, that is Jews who have been circumcised, there were six of them, which believed were astonished, as many as came with Peter, because that all the Gentiles also was poured out the gift of the Holy Ghost. Look at here. Verse 46. For on this account they heard them speak with tongues and magnify God. Then answered Peter, can any man forbid what? That these should not be baptized which have received the Holy Ghost as well as we. And he commanded them to be baptized in the name of the Lord. And he commanded them to be baptized in the name of the Lord. There's only one name whereby we're saved. It is the name of Jesus Christ. It happened in Acts chapter number 2. It happened in Acts chapter number 8. And it happened in Acts chapter number 10. And it happened in Acts chapter number 19. They were baptized in the name of the Lord. You say, man, you told us so much today. You talked about so much today. I just want you for just a second. Let's go on Cornelius' journey with it. From a devout life prayer given, instructed in his house, and he's led to a preacher who in that took the time of a command, would not even give him the time of day, but was also led of the Spirit into the revelation of the desire of God that every nation would indeed experience the power of the Holy Ghost. Just as the Jews did, to hearing the word Cornelius, to believe in the word, and being filled with the Spirit, and speaking with other tongues, which was the evidence that he had been filled with the Spirit. That's how the circumcision knew they got the Holy Ghost. And then there was one brought, and they were baptized in the name of the Lord Jesus. Understanding from the parallel journey of Peter, who had already been baptized in Jesus' name, who had already been filled with the Holy Ghost evidence by speaking in other tongues, that isn't the end of the journey, but it's the beginning. That simply being good is not good enough. But through faith in God and obedience to His Word, anyone and everyone can receive anything God has for them. Because we too are now aware that God is no respecter of persons. Please stand with me. Gotten a little bit messed up in our mind and a little bit messed up in our thinking. I'm sure Shannon and Rick.